this short, not only because we want to focus on Professor Timothy's introduction, but also because I lost my voice 3 days ago and I've not been able to regain it. So just a few remarks from my side. You referred to that I had been working in the Philippines for UNHCR. This is the High Commissioner for Refugees. That's actually 30 years ago. I came here in a younger version, and I wonder why I did not get married to a Filipino at that time. I must have been very busy in my work. Already at that time, I got fascinated by the design and ingenuity of Filipinos. And I remember also clearly that my local Filipino staff, they were wondering why I started doing this collection of baskets. I was based in Palawan, Puerto Princesa. There was a refugee camp for Vietnamese boat people. And I very, very soon got interested in the baskets the Palawanians are producing for rice containers to bring as a lunch back to the field and so forth, because they use the local material and they design it in such a way that's sustainable. It's doable. And so I actually made a collection of these baskets 30 years ago that I still have. It was not until I found out that there was a kind of a market for these baskets in Manila when I visited here, and I told my local staff, you should know that in the market here there's a pretty high value on these baskets. Then it became more interesting. I found a spontaneous interest in that, to see how they can use local materials to produce a thing that serves a function. And I think this is very much what we also will hear much more about when we start listening to Timothy, Professor Timothy. This initiative that Jacob Jensen designed is now coming in here and want to partner with a Philippine partner. It's very interesting. And I see it fits extremely well with the policy of the Duterte government. The Duterte government presented last year a 10-point socio-economic agenda. And this is, for me, a very progressive and future-oriented agenda that is there. If all the things in this agenda can be implemented, Philippines will be a better place in within the time of Duterte. Number 8 on this agenda is saying we want to promote technology and innovation and creative arts to make it possible for the industry to further develop the economy in a sustainable way. And this initiative that we are going to talk more about here today fits perfectly into this ambition of the Duterte government. So I'm very happy that this is very much aligned to the political ambition of the government here. I should say about Jacob Jensen that this is not something anonymous.